the Senate Standing Committee on Cultural Affairs, Tourism, Parks, and Recreation. And then we will have a discussion following our agenda, which is, should be pretty quick. Senate Bill 2708 by Senator Golden.
An act to amend Chapter 912 of the laws of 1920, allowing and regulating boxing, sparring, and wrestling matches, and establishing a state boxing commission in relation to exempting white-collar boxers from the provisions of such act.
Thank you. Any questions, discussion? Move the bill. Thank you. And all those in favor? We are. Thank you. The bill passes. Senate Bill 4720 by Senator Young.
An act to amend the Parks, Recreation, and Historic Preservation Law in relation to oil and gas drilling in Allegheny State Park.
Okay, any discussion?
Move it.
Bill is moved. All in favor? Aye. Bill is passed. Senate Bill 4861 by Senator Grippo.
An act approving the exchange of certain lands between National Grid and the people of New York State.
Okay, and a motion to move the bill.
Motion.
And discussion? All those in favor? Bill by me, Senate Bill 4988.
An act to amend the Arts and Cultural Affairs Law in relation to consignment of works of art to art merchants by artists, their heirs, and personal representatives.
Any questions, discussion? Move the bill. All those in favor?
Aye.
And the bill is passed. Senate Bill 5182 by Senator Marcelino.
An act to amend the Arts and Cultural Affairs Law in relation to works of art in the Empire State Plaza, to amend the General Business Law in relation to the rules and regulations for nail specialty, natural hair styling, aesthetics, and cosmetology, to repeal Article 4 of the Arts and Cultural Affairs Law in relation to the Empire State Plaza Art Commission, to repeal Section 433A of the General Business Law in relation to the Barbers Board, and to repeal Section 844A of the Executive Law in relation to the New York Statewide Law Enforcement Telecommunications Committee.
Okay, this is just really trying to streamline some of these regulations, not as complicated as it sounds.
Okay.
All right.
Move it.
All right, bill is moved. All those in favor?
Aye.
And Senate Bill 5372 by me.
An act to amend Chapter 138 of the laws of 1998, amending the navigation law and the state finance law relating to the operation of personal watercraft and specialty prop craft in relation to extending the effectiveness thereof.
That extends the date. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. And the bill is passed. And Senate Bill 5534 by Senator Livis.
An act to amend the Parks, Recreation, and Historic Preservation Law in relation to expanding the Susquehanna Heritage Area.
Any discussion? Move the bill. All those in favor? Aye. And the bill is passed. And thank you.
Oh, we have a supplemental agenda.
Oh, I forgot. I did agree to that. I don't have it. All right. Senate Bill 5342 by Senator Grisanti.
An act to amend the Parks, Recreation, and Historic Preservation Law in relation to draft management plan submission dates.
Okay. Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
And the bill is passed. Thank you. And we have Assemblyman Steve Engelbright is here with us today in regard to do a little bit of discussion. This is our last tourism meeting, unless something happens and we have to have another one, but for the most part, we think this is it. And Ed Matino has come in from I Love New York program. I want to have a seat. And
sure.
We're hoping next year to have an Arts Day, and we have scheduled it for the first Wednesday in March, which is our first four-day week. So it won't be Tuesday, which is kind of crazy, so Wednesday might be it. We have scheduled it for one of the hearing rooms, and we hope to have some art displays and to have some entertainment, and really to try to get people focused on the value of arts to the economy in New York State, and it's before the budget. So we thought that would be kind of important to do that. So ideas and part of the program, how we're going to put it together, really be looking for. If you have someone that you think you'd like to have, a vocalist, Chris Cernick represents the Grammys, he said he would get some entertainment.
Be a day long kind of thing?
I think we were thinking maybe 10 to 12, and then have some displays out in the hallways, and you know, hopefully have a lot of the legislators come in and out. Assume that the session would start in the afternoon, usually, so 10 to 12 would probably, unless you have different ideas.
Is NISCA still going to exist by this time of year?
Yeah, we should, we hope.
Yeah, yeah. And we're going to talk to them too, so we have talked to the Arts Council.
They're coming in next week.
Next week, okay. So we'll see, we'll definitely get them on board.
Do they have a new executive director?
Not that I've heard.
You said they left a couple of weeks ago, wasn't it?
Yep.
Okay, I'll find all that out.
Yeah.
But if you have some ideas and you have some thoughts on it, you know.
And you want to have it in the well?
It's going to be one of the hearing rooms, and then maybe the area outside the hearing room. Fill it up with some displays, we have some art displays, you know. I have a children's art museum that might want to send some things down that could be displayed or some of that. But then the other thing I wanted to talk about is having a museum day. And at first we thought maybe we would do that in May, like before the summer, before the end of session, and invite all the museums in the state that wanted to have a display, fill the hallways, the walkways, where everybody is, to, you know, have brochures and just get people interested in knowing more about the museums and maybe help them visit. But then I had a call, I was talking to my son who's in Colorado Springs, and they were going to a museum because it was Museum Week in Colorado. And they, it was free admission. I mean, if you did any of the special tours, you paid for those, but you could get into the museum and do all that for Colorado residents all that week. And it's kind of before Memorial Day. It was before the season really starts. Mm-hmm. But I would think it would be a good marketing tool. And I went online, Wisconsin has a Museum Week. Maryland, I think, was the other state that had a Museum Week. I found several of them. And I wondered if it'd be worth doing in New York and saying that we have a Museum Week. I love New York Museum Week or something like that. Probably that week before Memorial Day, and then maybe we'd have Museum Day down here the week before that. Mm-hmm. And we have so many museums.
Yeah, I mean, it's a great, and we talked briefly about it. I think it's a great idea. Of course, the important thing would to get all the museums to buy into it. We tried a little bit of that when NISCA had their 50th year anniversary, which I think was just last year, and we tried to get that off the ground. And we, in terms of the promotion, because that's what we really try to get is a lot of the museums to buy into it. What I really like is the idea of you know, going outside of Museum Mile, going outside of New York City, and getting consumers exposed to all the great art that is outside of Metro New York, and there's abundance of it. So I love the thematic part of it. We're tying it all together to the great assets we have. It's a lot of work to try to get the whole industry to buy into it. So with our stretch resources, I mean, let's take a look at it and see if NISCA can certainly help, and if they have some resources that we could pull together, maybe partner. You know, if you want to kind of springboard it here, maybe get OGS to get involved and see if they can give us some display down in the on the concourse, and then have a week from there. It's a great idea.
Yeah, okay. We'd have a day, and then we'd have, probably in the concourse, we'd get more people. Mm-hmm. And then we would have the museum week. And I would think, well, first of all, I have an intern that's going to work in the Glens Falls office this summer. He's from Blue Mountain Lake, a college student. And I was thinking of using this as a project. So he could call some of the museums, see what their level of participation would be, what they thought of it. And maybe they could participate in different ways. Maybe some would want free admission. Maybe we'd go with a two-for-one admission.
Right.
But maybe we'll prepare some questions that we can ask, that he can ask different, you know, as he makes these calls, mm-hmm. and see what the level of participation is, and you know, whether it's a 20% off or 10% off in a gift shop or whatever. But I would think they would benefit that week when they don't have a lot of visitors anyway. And if we could get people to get into these museums and bring their kids, you know, they'll come back, they'll bring other people. But I want to...
No, you saw it as an awareness and also to drive, you know, consumers into museums. I think it's a great idea. And I'm very, most especially happy you're bringing it up in June of 2011. Because it definitely would take a lot of planning to do. And
it's going to take a lot of time, and we need I Love New York to be part of it.
Mm-hmm.
And to help market it.
Yeah, well, we'd be happy to look at it, but I think you're right. Just kind of getting an idea of how the industry would react to it would be the first step.
We do have the Museum Association here.
Thank you. Any thoughts? You have some thoughts on this, or you can help me with questions?
I think it's a great idea, and I think it I don't think it's going to be a real problem getting museums and to buy into this, and especially if they're allowed to choose whatever they want to do. So it's not a set thing, you must give free admission or you must do this. I think there's not going to be any problem. They're going to embrace it.
Okay.
Very definitely. I think it's a great idea.
And then we need some kind of consistent marketing tool,
right,
all that
right.
kind of stuff. Right. But and I'll work with you so that
Absolutely.
We can formulate the questions mm-hmm. that we'll have this young guy ask when he calls around and see what you think.
I think it's a great idea, Betty, and that your intern is from Blue Mountain Lake, the home of the Adirondack
Museum.
is somehow very fitting. It's one of the great museums of the state. The only thing I would encourage is to try to use this also as a forum for the state historic sites, not just art museums, but history museums and natural history, natural science museums. We're all part of the same family of museums in the state.
Oh yeah, we have a Slate Museum in Granville.
There you go.
We have the Pember Museum. Oh, they have every stuffed bird and stuffed bug that ever was on the face of the earth. And it's, you know, you have to go upstairs to see it, but when you go there, you just look at these case after case after case. No, it's really buggy. But then we have the Wild Museum, we have the Wild Center in Tupper Lake, that new museum. So, and I have the Hyde Museum, which is free all the time anyway. So I have a ton of museums in my district, and I can just imagine that everybody else has them in theirs. But I think as you start into summer and people start planning their vacations and looking for things to do, why not highlight New York State museums and say, you know, take a trip, visit a museum. I'm sure we could come up with taglines and ad lines and do some stuff like that. And,
a lot of potential.
Okay. But like I said, I sometimes have ideas that I haven't really thought out. So I need a lot of input.
There's precedents too. I mean, there are over 100 museums all across the state that are participating in the Blue Star Museum project that's promoted by the National Endowment for the Arts. Museums are opening their doors. That program opens museum doors to veterans and active duty servicemen and their families,
okay.
servicemen and women and their families. So they're used to this kind of promotion. Granted, we need time, but I think that you will find a willing audience.
Okay.
Definitely.
All right, and then we'll work with you. Mm-hmm. And when we get this fellow on board, this will be his project. And you know, hopefully we can keep you all posted, and we'll put out memos as to where we are mm-hmm. and what we're finding out. And we'll have, you know, just like 5 or 6 questions that he asks every one of them, and to their level of participation and what they think the best promotion. But it's so easy to promote online and websites and all that kind of stuff. So it's cheap. Really.
Are you sending these out to museums just in your region or statewide?
Statewide.
And you have a list?
Yeah.
We've got a list.
Yeah. But you know, I think it wouldn't hurt for New York State to have I Love New York Museums.
Mm-hmm.
I Love New York Historic Sites. I Love New York Parks. I Love New York Beaches. I Love New York. You know, develop mm-hmm. just so that when people went on your website, they could
yeah,
we
have
what they're looking for.
Pretty robust database with that, and we try to indeed market the I Love New York brand to specific, you know, themes. But you know, to highlight it in a week, I think as a promotional tool is a really good idea.
Okay, we'll have to have legislation naming that week New York State Museum Week. But we won't do that until January.
Mm-hmm.
But we've got to be ready to go on board with all
mm-hmm.
that stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And then the Arts Day, we'll be looking for participation. If you know of any artists that would want to come down, and you know, if we could highlight, you know, a jazz group, and even if we had a couple groups out in the hallway playing music.
It's time to have some fun, right?
Yeah, really.
Been through a couple rough years, haven't we?
Yeah, really, just kind of get people on board with, you know,
sure.
We've got so much to promote.
We do.
You know, they could have, if somebody wanted to do some art displays, they could bring some pieces down. And, there's just so much going on, and you know, multiply it by all the other districts. And I, you know, don't know what's going on in all the other districts as much, but certainly know it's got to be about the same. Although mine's the best, definitely. So we'll need help with both things, but I think it'd be fun for the committee to sponsor this and to work with Steve and his committee and you know, you can have, like, I have this pianist that is outstanding. He's a senior in high school, he's graduating, and he has a jazz group that plays around, and, mm-hmm. and they're all high school kids. So everybody has things like mm-hmm. that, you know? We could get somebody down. We have a high school group, the Magical Singers, that, you know, they perform all over Europe and do all that, and they're not that far away. So that kind of thing, that we could have some entertainment, some speakers, and just showcase the arts in New York State. Music, art, whatever.
Yeah, that's a good idea. I think we could give I Love New York program an opportunity to promote itself and its program, too. And one of the takeaways from the Cornell study, as we've been talking about, is really registers very high with consumers coming to New York and looking for the assets is arts, is museums, and live events. So as we're doing our 2012 planning right now, we're trying to factor in as a live from New York kind of thematic approach, and we're going to have a lot of just what we're talking about in terms of museums and live events. So it would really, I think, dovetail very well into our 2012 planning.
Okay.
You're ahead of the curve.
Okay, good. Well, all right, but I need help, and I need ideas, and all that kind of stuff, but it'd be fun to work on. Okay, so we'll go ahead.
All right, good. When you get your intern online, so to speak, you know, be sure to be in touch.
Okay.
You'll, thank you.